The fundamental idea behind the boogeyman is that he has no distinguishing history, which is what makes the concept effective. Only when the boogeyman is revealed to be human, given a profile, does he become less of a tool for the moral being taught. The notion is characterized by a common trait. The fears of the conjuring party, us, are what creates the boogeyman ultimately. We project our fears onto the idea. In a sense, the boogeyman is really us.
Hello? Shut up! Son of a bitch! I need to sleep! Denny.
Rachel, what can I do for you?
I'm trying to sleep, but my neighbor is tapping on the wall.
Tapping?
That's right.
From which side?
The bedroom side.
That would be apartment 237. Are you sure, Rach?
Yeah.
That apartment's empty. Has been for a while. Got a little case of the heebie-jeebies? Huh, Rach?
Rachel. I know I heard something.
You hear anything else, give old Danny a call. I'll look into it personally.
My hero.
Anything to the damsel in distress.
Good night.
Wait, knock, knock, knock.
Really, Denny?
Come on, it's a good one.
Who's there?
Boo.
Boo hoo.
Why are you crying?
Good night, moron.
Wanna go out with me?
And your time is up.
Thank you. in there, Denny. I can hear it.
That's impossible. These walls are super thick.
I saw them.
Hello?
All right, I checked the apartment. Empty.
Are you sure?
Yep, completely vacant.
Thanks for checking.
Rach, there isn't anyone over there. You're completely alone.
Denny, I'm so sorry! I'm so sorry!